We're in the penultimate part of this series now, and I've been saving some of the tricky stuff till last. The wire passes over the face for only a few frames in the shot, but getting this looking good enough is going to be a challenge, not least because a lot of the viewer's focus naturally starts on the face. So let's look at the problems and solutions to fixing this traveling wire back in silhouette. So let's take a look at how that would work, shall we? So come into my nodes, let's go to paint. In fact, just to speed things along a little bit, there we go. I'm going to set up my work range, which is 0 to 12. There we go. And I'm going to use my paint source to be the original, and then I can just comp it over the top. It's going to give me a bit more flexibility, I think. And we can see that nasty frame right at the very start. Oh, I do not like that. So what we're going to do with these frames? There's a couple of issues just to be aware of. And the big one is there's a slight lighting change as the face turns towards the camera. Or sorry, turns towards the sun, turns away from the camera. How big a problem that's going to be, I'm not sure yet, but we'll figure that out as we go along. But looking at that movement, I think that's going to be all right for a straightforward clone, especially on the face. The neck is might be a different thing, but on the face, I think we might be all right. I'm going to need another track. So I'm going to come into my tracker, which has been conspicuous in our node tree right from the very beginning. And I'm going to create another layer and call this one face. And turn on my overlays. Let's bring this in here. I'm going to choose a shape where things are moving in a coplanar way. So everything's moving in the same sort of way. I'm also going to add another shape. We've seen this many times now, but it's a shape for my wire removed because I don't want to add my wire to this planar track. I'll call this one wire and I'll call this one face. And I'm going to put my wire in a new layer above that's going to count towards the tracker. There we go, and set my layer to subtract, come into my face, and I'm going to use the mocha tracker. So I have my layer set up, my face and my wire, have those in, and set this to, I do want perspective in as well. I'm going to leave everything else at default values and just track that forwards. That looked like it tracked in nicely. Let's track the first frame. Boom, there we go. Now it's vitally important that when we're doing this sort of paint work that we have absolutely solid tracking data. Because if we don't, we might as well not have any tracking data. It's just going to make our life horrible. So let's come in, check our stabilization on the active layer, just play that through. And I think on the face, looking pretty good. A little bit of movement, a little bit of turning, but I think that's pretty good. Most of the turning, it could actually be on the neck instead. Okay, so we've got a good face. We'll figure out what we're going to do with the neck in a little bit, but we've got a good face. So let's pipe our tracking data into our paint node and let's have a look what happens when we come to clone. Okay, I want to start cloning on a good frame. This is not a good frame to start with because, as we can see, this is, you know, an aberrant frame. We don't want to start cloning on that. And I do want to see if I can grab data that's already there. But by the time that we can actually see what's going on with her face, the wire's gone and it's kind of not going to be great. So here's a way we can use the clone with the transform that we did. So I'm going to come into transform and I want to just turn on interactive here. And now as I move through the frames, you can see it's kind of skipping through the frames, yeah? If I turn on source match move, when I've got my transform on, this is going to use the transform data we created to kind of try to bring us out and bring us a clear face. So let's see if I can use this to build up one single frame. turn my opacity up. Let's turn the softness up, turn the opacity down, 7, turn my build up on. And in that way, I can just start to gently go over the same area a few different times. Now, this is not going to be perfect. It's just going to help us to clean up some of that wire, at least at the start. Once I've done that, I've got a little bit more flexibility now to come in. Maybe I'll come to my, you know, trusty drag tool, bring the opacity up, turn the build up off, but turn my mix down, and I can try to build up the, I'm just trying to build up the skin tone a little bit here. I get a little bit more confident with that, with where I'm at. I'll turn the opacity back up. There we go. Get the opacity down just a little bit here. Just bring that in. 2 and 1, just to have a quick look at the before and after. Don't really need to do the wire itself, but it just gives me a better idea of what we're looking at. Cool. Got a little bit of the mouth there. I'll just eat away at the mouth. Then I'll come in with my color, last little bit. Take the opacity down low again, about 5. And I can right click to sample the color that I want to click sample from. And I can just paint back that mouth, sampling through another few colors again. And then happily use an eraser, bring us back in there, sample that original color one more time. If I right click and drag, it will give me an average of those colors. Very nice. Come back in with the eraser. Just make sure I'm not going too far. Excellent. So that's one frame. Now, when I'm happy with that one frame, I'm going to use this now to then build up the rest of the frames, because what I really want to avoid doing is get inconsistencies between frames. So here's how we're going to do that. Let's come back to my clone tool. I'm going to reset everything on the clone tool. So we're starting from scratch. I've still got my transform here and then reset the frame number. Okay, let's come to the next frame, on frame 2 now. I'm going to turn off relative on the source frame. I'm going to turn on interactive. And we're going to come to frame 1. Frame 1 is the one we just painted up, yeah? And let's turn on source match move. So it still looks like we've now got double wires. Why is that? Well, that's because our source is still set to input. If I set that to output, it's now going to take those wires away. Why is this important? Well, it now means with my clone tool, get the brush a bit bigger. Let's reset my brush, turn the softness back up on it, zoom in, and we'll take the opacity down just a little bit. So now when I paint, we're bringing in from the other frame. I'm going to be a bit wary about the mouth, or a bit careful with the mouth, I should say, because the mouth is going to be troubling. I'm going to say troublesome, but it's also going to be troubling. The neck as well, that's going to be a bit of an issue. I'm just going to be extra specially careful around the mouth. I'll probably come back to that and do those afterwards. I'm going to turn my softness down now because the wire is going over a hard edge. And I'm constantly sampling from frame 1 with that transform. So the colors may not be 100% right, but they're going to be consistent. We can fix the other stuff. I'm not trying to do everything in one pass. That's the other important note. Just trying to cover all of this stuff up first. Do as little work as possible. And when we're free, then we're free. Cool. Oh yes, I should also do frame one as well. It's going to be a little tougher. Okay, so now we've got the sort of rough notes played in. I basically just laid my color in there. I'm now going to come through and start to just fade that in a little bit. I'm just going to blend in a little bit with the drag tool. Trusty drag. What the drag tool also means I can do is once I've laid, now these colors have been laid in, I can start to come in and sort of blend those back together so that we keep that idea of 3D and keep the idea of the changing light source as well. Just finish that up and we're free. And as soon as we're free, it's going to come into the color tool and just very quickly, very roughly paint out the actual wire. Just again, just so we get an idea of where we're at. Now, luckily, most of this is contained or is already tackled by the wire remove masks that we did. Wasn't a very nice blue. Let's resample that and just get a little bit of this lip back in again. Very annoying lip, by the way. And we'll just, there we go, smooth that out with a bit of drag. Always with the drag tool. Drag tool is probably one of my favorite tools. So many sins can be hidden with the drag tool. Give a little bit of different color to those teeth. Opacity all the way down. Dot, there we go. Add in some teeth here as well. I'm not sure what's going on with this one. Oh yeah, this is the first frame. There we go. I haven't even done the drag on this one. Bring the opacity back up again. Whoop. God, if we could get away with it, I would be very happy just to drop this first frame. And a less honest person than myself would have dropped it before you even saw it. Let's just lay that in. Okay, and we'll turn off stabilization. We've done that already. Good. Play that through. And as a first pass, you can see where the difficulty is going to lie with the frame by frame. Because we don't have that nice consistency going through, we can easily get this kind of flickery, flimmery sort of look going to it. But I'm going to do another little round on this, and through the magic of editing, we will see how it looks in the end. So I'll see you after I've smoothed some of the stuff out. And to finish up in exercise 15, we'll be adding the final polish to our shot and see some of the last few tricks to rid ourselves of the last of these wires.